Hi, welcome back. The last video we discussed about static storage classes. Among the four storage classes, we discussed automatic, automatic and static. We discussed in the previous classes, and today we are discussing about another storage class, that is registers. So, register. What is register? We already studied that in your previous semester that. In computer memory is divided into two. First one is primary memory and the second one is secondary memory. In primary memory, we have RAM, registers and cache. So cache memory is there, register memory is there, and RAM, random access memory, is there so these are the three type of memory in primary memory. The secondary memory, hard disk, floppy, pen drive, everything that is considered as a secondary memory. So these registers are the memories used for these calculations and all. Okay, so this memory is available in the motherboard. So the it's a temporary memory. Once the power gets off, the memory will be erased, and once the system gets switched on, the memory, a fresh memory, that means the value available on the memory in the previous session, will be cleared or erased, and a new memory is used for storing and processing and everything. So if we are declaring a variable, then if we need, because register memory has advantage that it's faster than all other memories, it's faster than random access memory, it's faster than cache memory. Among these primary memories, out of this primary memory, like registers, cache and RAM, register is faster than all the other two, cache and RAM. Again, cache is slower than register and faster than RAM, and RAM is slower than both registers and cache. And in terms of size, the size of the register is too small while comparing to the cache memory and random access memory. Similarly, cache memory is little bit larger than registers and smaller than RAM. So cache memory is larger than registers and smaller than RAM, and RAM is larger than both registers and cache memory. So this is a concept behind this. So register, why we are using register is if we need to access the variable too fast, that means some of the access, some of the variables or the values available in the variable has to be accessed frequently. Okay, so at that time we are using the memory of a register so that we will get the values very easily, faster, and processing also will be very fast. So for that we are using registers. That is the main intention of using the registers. The variables defined as a register is allocated the memory into the CPU registers depending upon the size of the memory remaining in the CPU. So CPU memory is, it's a very small amount of memory available in the register. So it's not allocated for the compiler, it's for all other purposes in the computer. If a CPU is running for a long period of time, the process or the activities happening inside the CPU may use registers. So at the time if you are running our program, so the compiler will verify whether the registers has enough memory to allocate. If the memory is allocated, then memory, the register variable will be stored in that memory. So that is the concept here. The variable defined as a registers is allocated the memory into the CPU registers depending upon the size of the memory remaining in the CPU. That is very important, the size of the memory remaining in the CPU. Okay. So all other cases, normal automatic variables, it's not like that. Memory is available because it's taking the memory, but that memory may be very large in size. So we can allocate the memory without any problem. But in this case of registers, we have a restriction, like if the size of the memory remains there, then we can allocate, or the compiler can allocate a memory for the variable from the registers. Okay. Second point, we cannot dereference the register variables. That means we cannot use ampersand operator for the register variable. So usually what we are doing with ampersand operator, if you want to find the address of a particular variable, listen, if you want to find the address of a particular variable, then what we will do, we will use the ampersand operator. So that is the meaning of dereference. So we cannot dereference the register variable. That means we cannot find out the address of that particular variable. Okay, because it's stored in a registers. The access time of register variable is faster than the automatic variables. That I already told you, that register memory is faster than all other primary memories. Okay, I am not comparing with secondary memories. I am comparing register with all other primary memories. So register is faster than all other primary memories like cache and random access memory. So this is faster than automatic variable. That is why it is said to be faster than automatic variable. So automatic variables may be stored in cache memory or random access memory. That is why it's faster. The registers are faster than these automatic variables. The initial default value of the register local variable is 0. Okay, it's nothing more important than because it's a default value. If you are not assigning any value on that particular variable, then automatically the compiler takes 0 for that particular variable. Okay, and register keyword is used for the variable which should be stored in the CPU register. Keyword used for declaring a variable as register is just register. We can store pointer into the register. What's the meaning of that? That we will discuss in that while discussing pointer concept. So in the next module we will have a pointer module. So at that time we will detailedly discuss about pointers. So just note it down, pointers into the registers. Okay, we can store pointers into the registers. That is, the register can store the address of another variable. That is the meaning of a pointer variable. So a variable can store the address of another variable is that concept is considered as pointer. So such variables are considered as pointer variables. Okay, so we can store pointers into the registers. Then static variables cannot be stored into the registers since we cannot use more than one storage specifier for the same variable. That is important. Static variables cannot be, we cannot make a static variable as, or we cannot store a static variable in the registers. Why? Because what's the meaning of a static variable? In the last class we discussed, so static variables are holds their values between multiple functions. So holds the values between multiple functions. So that means the memory is reallocating based on the activity. Okay, but in our case, in this case, we cannot use such kind of that more than one storage specifier for the same variable. So that is why we cannot store static variable in registers. Okay. Let me run this program. So this is a example program for this. So this is a static variable. Default value for the static variable is 0. So what you have to do is use the keyword register in front of the normal variable declaration so that it will be considered as a register variable. Okay. So if the value is assigning as 10, then that's all. So the concept is we are storing this value in a register memory. That's all. Okay. Where is this? And if you are using ampersand operator to print the address here, it will show error. So we cannot use. Okay, we cannot use this kind of accessing. Okay, so this is the concept. That means scanf statement cannot be used. We have to initialize the value manually. That is why I am telling you that a standard constant value that in our program, like pi value, pi 3.14, we have to continuously use the value of pi 3.14 for the calculations inside the program. So that is a constant value. It may not be varying. So that value has to be frequently accessed by the programmer, by the program to produce the output. Such cases are using here in the case of registers. So we have to frequently access that value, constant values like pi value, then some constant values like pi. So such values has to be accessed frequently. So all those cases can be considered here as register. That is why ampersand, normally in this case of scanf statement, if you want to store a value in the scanf statement, what we will do, ampersand, with the help of ampersand, we can save the value. But in this case, if you are using registers, we can't do that. Okay. So that is the meaning of this register. Thank you for watching the video.